can win the blocking battle, because I think that will be the difference here in the championship match.
This is the biggest game of the 2015 season. It's the game that will wrap up the 2015 season, and it is the biggest prize purse in the history of international beach volleyball. 100 grand up for grabs on the winner. Alison gets the action underway, serves Lucina. Dellhauser with a perfect set. Nick the quick puts the first ball down for the United States of America. It's the perfect start for the home heroes.
Nick's going to get a lot of action, you can expect, because he is somewhat untested in this duo, and no one wants to go to Big Phil.
Lucina serves to Alisson. Set from his partner. A good side out for Brazil. That could be the pace and style of the game in the early exchanges. Trading side outs, each side in the early part.
No question about it that this is going to be an equal matchup. They're going to try to feel one another out. Remember, they played in this tournament before in pool play, and the Americans had the edge.
Lovely set for Nick Lucina. Alisson's at the net. Dellhauser sees it. Great defensive work from the Americans. Great play to take the third point and to go 2-1 up.
You know what I love about that play? You got Big Phil Dellhauser, 6'9", covering his partner. If you can negate a block from Alisson, it can be frustrating for the Brazilians. Look at Alisson. Get the block, throw it down. But there's Phil. He keeps it in play and is able to put it away. Great play for Team USA.
Dellhauser, superb reactions. And it is Phil Dellhauser with service for the United States of America. A one-point advantage over Brazil. Goes straight to Alisson with a power serve. Alisson now on the attack. The break. Oh, the block not there for Phil Dellhauser. He cuts that ball nicely. No answer from the Americans. The scores are tied.
You can see Phil Dellhauser taking the line away. They're trying to force Alisson to hit cross court. Lucena's there, but he's hitting a very sharp angle. The United States is going to have to make an adjustment.
Bruno Schmidt. Oh, a little bit of help from the net. Both of the Brazilian players make an indication to the Americans that wasn't meant to be. A little bit of lady luck for Team Brazil, who take a 3-2 lead.
Anytime you get a little roll over the net like that, you'll take it any day of the week. The United States has to be aware.
Youngest player on court, Bruno Schmidt with service to Lucina. Now Lucina, Nick the quick on the attack. Oh, Alisson is there. And the ball is given to Brazil. They take a two-point lead over Dellhauser and Lucina.
Wow, that ball ruled inbounds. Initially, the sidelinesman called it out, but look at the press with the right hand by Alisson. Beautiful block.
Brunos with service. Different tactic this time from Nick Lucina, but the ball is out of play. Total points score of 7, side switch. Brazil 3 clear.
Yeah, Nick's going to have to be careful with that. He's got big Alisson in his way. He tries to go down the line. It has to be too precise, and he errs just wide. That was the right shot, but very difficult to execute. They're going to continue to serve Nick the quick and to see if he can step up and rise up to the occasion.
Yeah, the Brazilians working hard to keep Phil Dellhauser out of the game here. Bruno Schmidt with service. Brazil now 3 clear in the opening set. Waiting for the referee's whistle. Service error.
Service error, a little out of pace there. That made Bruno wait a little bit, and he took his eye off the prize right there. That's an easy side out for Team USA. Let's see if they can use it.
Oh, great play from both teams here, keeping the ball up. Dellhauser with the block of the net. Alisson is down on the sand. And the American crowd are on their feet once again. Skill set from both players from either side impressive, but the Americans come out on top with the block.
Look at Bruno and Alisson keeping that ball alive, and then it is Big Phil taking the net, blocking it when both Brazilians are down. That's the first block for Phil Dellhauser.
Here's Lucina with service, serving to Bruno Schmidt. The set from Alisson. Almost a second block in succession for Dellhauser. Not quite there with the angle.
Just a little bit late hitting that cross court. It looks like they want to block the line, dig the angle, and the Brazilians have gotten out of that mix a few times so far. The U.S. has to make an adjustment.
Oh, the service is out from Alisson. Two service errors in the first 11 points from the Brazilians is helping the American tally.
Yeah, I talked about this being the biggest match for Nick Lucena that he has maybe ever been in. Of course, Phil Dahlhauser, the biggest match he was ever in, the 2008 finals in Beijing. He's got that experience. He is a gold medalist. And look at that serve!
Service ace from Phil Dahlhauser to level the scores at 6-6.
Oh! Phil Dahlhauser loves to line up in the middle of the court and then create his angles, that time going inside out, going down the line of Alisson, completely freezing him.
Beautiful play. Dahlhauser, little help from the net, straight to Alisson. Alisson on the attack for Brazil. Oh! He goes down the alley with great success.
Goes off that block, the right hand of Big Phil. So the team that can prevent runs of points, here you see right down the line, right down the alley, we call it, right between the blocker and the antenna.
Oh, Lucena caught just a few feet out of position. Side switch for both the teams, but Brazil now take a two-point advantage, 8-6.
Yeah, it's going to be very important that neither team allows the other team to get any type of run going. You get a point here and a point there, but you can't allow 2 and 3 points at a time.
Brazil in the first set of the men's gold medal match here at Fort Lauderdale Beach Park Centre Court Stadium. Bruno Schmidt with service. Dahlhauser sets the ball up for Nick Lucena. Oh, that's better. That will help his confidence as well. As the Olympic champ sitting next to me, Dane Blanton, has pointed out, by far the biggest tournament of Nick Lucena's career to date, and with the pressure of the home crowd as well, he's starting to find his rhythm and stride now.
Yeah, not only is Nick excited about this partnership, but all the fans are, especially throughout the country. They think that this team put together of Phil and Nick could be the most powerful duo for the Americans.
Oh, great work from Dahlhauser. Lucena spots the gap. Alisson sets it up for Bruno Schmidt. He too spots the gap, and it's right on the line. Credit where it's due to the Brazilian duo. Skillful play.
Bruno Oscar Schmidt, some call him the best player in the backcourt in the world. He digs the ball, but more importantly, he converts, putting the ball in that nice corner just out of reach of the extended arms of Nick Lucena.
Alisson with service. Serves to Lucena once again. Dahlhauser with the set.
Just blasts the ball cross court. Bruno's there, but even Bruno can't handle that one. Nick Lucena just peppering that ball, bringing the fire. You know, a lot of people call it fire and ice, a good chemistry. Nick is the fiery one on this duo, Phil the more passive one, and it's created a really electric partnership.
Oh, it's a real good cocktail, it's fair to say. Here is Dahlhauser with service for the USA. Oh, that's a costly service error as we get close to the halfway point of this first set. Brazil now leading 10-8. Phil will kick himself for that one. Bruno Schmidt with service, the Brazilian number two. Perfect. Oh! The referee not happy with the set.
Wow, that's a very tight set call. It's a double contact. The ball's got to come out clean when you set the ball overhand. And I think all the players are a little stunned that that was called a double contact. What the referee's doing now, he's setting a very high standard, and he's going to have to stick with that. So very tight set call. We'll see how the rest of the calls play out.
Bruno Schmidt again serves Nick Lucena. Up he goes, right down the middle, perfect.
You know, this duo got together. Phil Dahlhauser was playing with Sean Rosenthal, and Nick Lucena, he was playing with Theo Bruner, and in the lead for Olympic points, but Nick initiated the partner swap Now they've played in five tournaments. That ball goes in for Bruno. But now Nick and Phil have played in five tournaments. Guess what? They've been in the finals of four of those.
Technical timeout as the total score reaches 21 points, 12-9 to Brazil against the United States of America. Brazilians on top at the moment. Dane, if you were the coach, what would you call from the American duo here? Should they stick to the original tactic or spice it up and change their plan just a little?
Well, I like what they're doing right now. I'd like to see them get a little more traction. It's about the big plays, and if Big Phil can make a few blocks and a few aces from the back line, they're going to be in better shape. And of course, Nick in the backcourt, if he makes a dig, it's about converting those big points right now, and it's been pretty even so far. Phil Dahlhauser with one block and one ace. Bruno Oscar Schmidt has an ace, but outside of that, you know, Alisson hasn't had a block, so they're playing well. Nick is navigating around the block of Alisson very efficiently, and they're playing a high level. This is what we expected, a battle, and no one has been able to really take that edge from a blocking standpoint.
Just react to the ball.
And it will happen, because you're talking about the two best blockers in the world, and Alisson and Phil.
See if we can listen to that conversation.
I know you're not going to get much talk out of Big Phil there. Every once in a while, he'll say a few things. But Nick is the verbal one. He's the guy who's firing it up. And I think it's going to do great things for Big Phil Dahlhauser. He's matured over the years. You know, Todd Rogers took him under his wing. They ended up winning the gold medal. And now, Phil in a leadership position.
Listen to the crowd enjoying every moment of this huge match in terms of international beach volleyball. It couldn't get any better. It couldn't get any bigger. And it's the last major of the 2015 tour. Alisson and Bruno Schmidt, 12-9 ahead of Phil Dahlhauser and Nick Lucina. Here's Alisson with service for Brazil. Once again targeting Nick Lucina. Lucina on the attack for the Americans. Oh, the big block from Alisson. Good play from the Brazilians. After winning the World Championship gold in the middle of the summer, they've won a further four gold medals since then. And one of those came in Long Beach, where they got the better of Phil Dahlhauser and Nick Lucina. And that is why the Brazilians are playing with such confidence here. Same tactic again. Perfect set from Dahlhauser. Better shot from Quick Nick to get that point to your USA.
Yeah, it's a tall order for Nick Lucena. We knew that they were going to go after him. Remember, Nick just 6'1". He's having to face Alisson, who's 6'8" in his face every single time. Alisson finally got his first block, but Nick's doing a great job of navigating around him.
It's Phil Dahlhauser with service for the USA, trailing by three. Big power serve. Oh, the linesman flag goes up. The ball is out.
Phil's going for it. He's trying to get some aces. It's all about risk and reward. If you don't go for it, you're not going to get those points. But Phil's got to start manufacturing some aces.
Same tactical plan from the Brazilians. Bruno Schmidt serves to Nick Lucina. Oh, and Lucina bounces it off the tape of the net and out of the court. Five clear now, Brazil.
Here comes Nick. He tries to navigate around. He tries to go too sharp, hits this ball into the net directly. It doesn't hit the block of Alisson. And when you're going for a sharp angle and you hit the net, you usually run out of real estate. That's exactly what happened. The United States is going to challenge. What they're challenging is that the block touched the ball. I did not see it. We're going to get to see it on the replay. This challenge rule came in Rio. They started testing it. This is the second event they've tested it. You can challenge in or out, whether it touched the antenna or the net, or it touched the player as it went out of bounds, or a footfall. So every team has two challenges. Does this ball hit the block of Alisson? Absolutely not. Clearly just hitting the top of the net. So the United States, you start with two challenges. If you have two unsuccessful, you lose the opportunity to challenge again. So the United States with only one challenge left, Brazil with two.
Oh, is that too long? The flag stayed down. It's a good shot from Nick Lucina.
Ball is out of bounds, and Nick Lucina nets on the play.
Oh, no.
So the Americans somewhat falling apart here in these last few moments, and the Brazilians expanding this lead.
3 kills to 2 blocks. Impressive stats for the Brazilians. They're now 6 clear. Oh, and it fails for a second time. Same shot, unsuccessful for the local Florida boy, Nick Lucina. He shakes his head. He's frustrated. He's furious. And Brazil are now 7 clear in the first set. Must keep cool, must keep his composure.
Beautiful cross-court hit. Bruno Oscar Schmidt was right in the angle, but that shot a little bit too mesmerizing, ends up hitting right inside the line. But the strategy for Brazil right now is paying off. There is the serve stats for Brazil. 88% of their serves in. You can see on the left-hand side where the green and yellow are. They're serving Nick Lucena every single time. They're scoring on 24% of the time when they keep that ball in. So the strategy for Brazil working right now, all the pressure in the world is on Nick Lucena.
Oh, come on, Nick. You need to dig deep here. Center serves Bruno Schmidt. Alisson with the set. Oh, no luck for Dahlhauser at the net either.
This is where the Americans have gotten in trouble. Receiving serve. Not as much on the point scoring, but more the receiving serve. The Brazilians continue to target Nick Lucena on the right side. And then Alisson's putting up a nice big block and causing him all sorts of problems.
Better from Nick Lucena. Couldn't be a more important point on the board for the USA. 6 behind Brazil in the first set.
Now you're getting to kind of a little bit of panic time in terms of this set. You need to manufacture points, so you should expect Phil to really go for this serve.
He does just that.
He's not getting that rotation that he normally gets, and it's landing about 1 to 2 feet long. So you can see a little frustration on his face, not getting that traction and that control of the ball. Remember, it's very humid here. Sometimes you don't have the traction as you would normally.
Bruno Schmidt serves Lucina. Lucina now on the attack. Reads the court well, but Bruno Schmidt has got it covered. Dahlhauser cannot contain that power ball from the Brazilian. It is set point for Brazil.
Just a beautiful play by Team Brazil in terms of a defensive set. Alisson funnels the ball right down the line. Bruno laying it out. You can see that extension. More importantly, he braces himself, gets up, and then he converts the point to get to set point here in this championship final.
Bruno Schmidt with service. I think they'll stick to the tactic. Serving to Nick Lucena. The set has to come from Dahlhauser. Good play. That's the side out that we were expecting to see on a little more of a regular basis from the Americans.
Really solid hit by Nick, noticing that the block had dropped out. Now the Americans, trailing by 7, need a point urgently.
Bruno Schmidt up at the net against Dahlhauser.
That ball's out of bounds.
It's out of bounds. That's another point back for the Americans.
Hold on a second. The referee just called it in. I'm not really sure what happened there because both line judges called the ball out of bounds. And then the referee go ahead and overruled them both. So I think we're going to get another challenge here. Team USA could use their second challenge. No, they don't. They go to the sideline, and I guess the ball mark was close enough.
Well, again, a controversial finish to the first set, but I can confirm that Brazil have beaten the United States of America 21-13 in the first, meaning that Nick Lucena and Phil Dahlhauser must win the second set to stay in the match.
That was too close to call, even in the replay.
That would have been a difficult time for
the official challenge figuring that one out.
But the Brazilians showing some dominance there in that first set. Their strategy seemed to work. They went to Nick. They caused some frustration, some problems.
He couldn't get around the block at times and put that ball to the sand against Alisson. Because the thing is, when you're Nick Lucena, you get it by Alisson, and then you got to deal with the best defensive player in the world and Bruno back there. That's why this team is so good, and that's why they have won 5 of the last 6 tournaments that they've entered.
And if they take their 6 here, it will be the most single gold medals or victories in a season by a team on the FIVB World Tour since 2010, our statistics tell us. And that was Phil Dolhauser and Todd Rogers. Services in, 77% breaks, just 15% from the American duo. They need to improve on these serve stats, no question.
Well, they're serving all over the place right now. Not a real true strategy. They're trying to feel out, do we go to Alisson? Do we go to Bruno? Where the Brazilians, they're very clear cut. They know exactly where they're going. They're going to test Nick Lucena, and it's going to be a question if he can answer the call, because this is the biggest stage that Nick has played on. Hopefully the Americans can settle down here and start playing the game that we know that they're capable of. Surpassed the $1 million mark in the FIVB World Tour winnings when he won the pool. He currently is at $1,023,000 in FIVB winning in 87 events, and he will build upon that total here in the final.
We are live around the world. Let's show what Paul Lauderdale has made up on a count of 3, 1, 2, 3.
The crowd are loving this clash of the two biggest nations in the sport of beach volleyball. The United States of America in their own backyard here in Fort Lauderdale, Florida, going up against the Brazilian world champions, Alisson and Bruno Schmidt. And the crowd are doing everything they possibly can to try and lift the pace of the local heroes here in their quest to stay in this match. The Brazilians have won the first, 21-13. America must win the second to take it to a 3-set playoff.
I think what the Americans have to do when receiving service, Phil's going to have to go over on 2 to relieve a little more pressure from Nick. Oh, that ball was just a cannon exploding. Alisson powering it down the line, and with the big Phil Dolhauser right in his face.
The Brazilians picking up where they left off at the end of the first set. Bruno Schmidt again continuing this very impressive service run. Phil Dolhauser gets a good shot in and an important point on the board for the United States of America.
Yeah, I like what I see. Phil taking a little more court, wanting to pass that ball, relieve some of the pressure. For the United States, I don't think they're having a huge problem scoring points. It's receiving serve and getting that side out that has been difficult.
Great shot of Casey Patterson, one of the other American players in the crowd, cheering on his countrymen. Oh, great timing from Bruno Schmidt at the net to give Brazil a 2-1 lead.
He just has this uncanny ability to see when the blocker's fully committed. You see how high Phil is. He knows if he just dices it around the block away from Nick, that Phil cannot land and recover.
Brazilians getting into a rhythm and a very good stride here right now. You can see the look of confidence, an air about them that nothing's going wrong and everything's going right. Alisson with service to Nick Lucena once again. Oh, look at that for a dig from Bruno Schmidt. Boards out.
Good drop on the block by Phil. He recognized that the set wasn't in the optimum position for Brazil. He dropped off the net. Two defenders in Bruno's face. He tries to be too sharp and errs on the shot.
The Perfect set from Alisson for Bruno Schmidt. Right down the middle of the American court. 2 points clear once again at Brazil. Pretty straightforward textbook side out for the Brazilians. I agree with you, Dane. Maybe the Americans should go over on two. Every other attack. Bruno Schmidt is all over this court, defending beautifully and finishing perfectly.
He really is. I mean, waiting patiently, and that's how you play defense. He's in a full read mode. He waits, he sees the shot. Alisson's job is to make the shot go nice and high, give Bruno time to run it down, and then, more importantly, when he digs that ball, he's transitioning at 90% plus. Taking a look at the side-out attempts, 24 for the Americans to 15, and they're only 71% success rate. The Brazilians, 87%. That's a 16% difference when receiving serve for the Brazilians, and that is why they won the first set and are up 3 points here in set number two.
No change in the game plan. Again, service to Messina. Great shot, Nick. Very important side out as the Brazilians still striding the court with confidence. The Americans narrow the advantage to just 2 points. Phil Dullhauser with service. Dullhauser goes to Alisson. Oh, again, the Brazilians reading the court. Cross court for Alisson to maintain that Brazilian 3 point lead.
Seeing the court so well, Alisson taking a page out of the book of his partner Bruno and putting a nice shot to the deep corner. You know what I like about that is that Nick challenged the block. If you look at the stat sheet, Alisson only has one block, right? That means that Nick is erroring, hitting some balls out, or hitting the ball to Bruno in the backcourt. Challenge the block. He hasn't blocked you but one time. Challenge the block. If he starts to block you a few times, then go around it. But right now, Nick having too many unforced errors.
Here's Bruno Schmidt. Oh, and again, powers that ball down to the sand. Nick Lucina cannot stop it or keep the ball up. 3 point advantage remains with the Brazilians. They're now at 7-4. Bruno Schmidt once again serves directly to Nick Lucina. Oh, then. Wow. Great play and athleticism from the Brazilians. Here's Dullhauser on the attack. The ball is good.
Ball's out of bounds, clearly right there. Nick did not set him up the way he wanted it. Here comes the pass. This is early on in the play. Look at this layout by Bruno. That's why we call him the best defender in the world. Alisson keeps it alive. And then here, Phil has an easy pass, but the set ends up about 8-9 feet off the net. Phil cannot find the court. Another point for the Brazilians. The rainbow shot. The Brazilians not fooled by that. It ends up just a foot long. So complete command, the Brazilians right now, and the Americans will call a timeout. If you're wondering, this is the 62nd FIVB World Tour men's gold medal match between the United States and Brazil. And guess what? Brazil holds a one match lead, 31-30. When the United States plays one another, Brazil got the lead, of course, in Long Beach when they took down this team. Looking at the comparison, Alisson 5-2 in kills over Phil Dullhauser and 2-1 in blocks. So having an edge in both departments, not only is Alisson getting more kills and blocks than Big Phil, it is Bruno who's making more defensive plays than Nick Lucena on the other side of the net. So we're seeing some total domination.
Yeah. over 4,500 spectators. Every seat in the house has been taken at center court here in Fort Lauderdale Beach Park. They're under a little bit of pressure here, Team USA, in front of their home crowd. Brazil took the first set 21-13, and they're now 9-4 clear in the second. The Americans must win the second set to stay in this gold medal match. Oh, that's a better shot. Right into the chest and face of Bruno Schmidt.
Yeah, fine switch. If I'm thinking I'm Nick and things aren't working, you know what? I'm going to go down swinging. I'm going to start hitting that ball nice and hard right there. He clips Bruno right into the chest, and that's what you're going to have to challenge him so that they know that you're going to unleash on them, so it's not easy for them to run down shots.
Phil Dolhauser with service. The Brazilians playing a tactical game to try and keep Phil out of the match as much as possible. It's been effective thus far. Dolhauser's service now is key to the American success in the second set. Alisson with the set. Bruno Schmidt again judges Phil Dolhauser's block at the net to perfection. 5 points clear now, Brazil 10-5, marching on in the second set.
Big Phil trying to get some traction at the net. See how the blocker jumps just after the offensive player to time it just right, but the shot too high.
Oh.
Bruno all over it right there. You know, Phil Dolhauser, if you can believe it, has won at least one FIVB title in each of the last 10 years, the longest streak on tour. His consistency has been absolutely incredible.
What a great float serve from Nick Lucina. Just picked up out of the net. Finally, Phil Dolhauser gets into the match with his big power block. And this could be the Americans on a roll.
That all started with the serve of Nick Lucina. Instead of serving it deep, he decided to go short, take the approach out of Alisson, and it worked. Here comes another short serve. High off the block of Phil Dolhauser and out of bounds, unfortunately. I like this mix-up right now. They're making some adjustments that may give them a slight advantage.
Well, something's got to change in the tactical approach from Team USA here. Split second off of this timing, Dolhauser there. Here's the set. Attack from Lucina. Smashes it off the hands of Alisson.
American
point.
They have to start striking right now. There's a nice high hit off the block. Challenge the block. Remember, not a lot of blocks so far for Alisson, so go at him. You see the hand signals from Nick to his partner.
Oh, it's another service error from Phil Dolhauser. That allows the Brazilians to take a 4-point advantage.
Been a big difference, Phil's serve, the fact that it has not been a factor. That's a weapon for him that he relies on dearly, and he just hasn't been able to make it happen.
Great block at the net from Alisson, but the second time of asking, Dolhauser puts it away.
Really good cover by the Americans, giving themselves a second opportunity. You're seeing the communication right now, but a little frustration. You see the hands going out to the sides by both players. Be nice to hear what they are saying in that American timeout box over there. They have to switch their strategy.
Well, the crowd doing everything that they can to lift the Americans here.
Good shot.
Here's Big Nick going high off the block, having to cover himself. And then Phil, instead of setting Nick, decides, I see an open spot in the deep corner over the block of Alisson and out of reach of Bruno Oscar Schmidt. Taking a look at the service stats, Brazil, 94% of the serves inbound. If you can see on the left, the heat map, yellow and green, they're serving right-sider. That would be Nick Lucina. They are staying away from Big Phil. 21% of the time they're scoring. In volleyball, you 85% of the time when you're receiving serve, you're usually successful. But right now, they have the Americans down to 79%, and that has been the slight edge. The Brazilians scoring on 21% of the time. On the other side of the net, the Americans, look at their serves all over the map. Not a true strategy there. 82% inbounds there, and 9% of the time only are they scoring. What does that mean? 91% of the time, the Brazilians are taking care of business when they're receiving serve.
To the second half of the second set. This is a real test for Team USA. Alisson on the attack.
There's a double contact, or a lift he's going to call it. Nonetheless, it's an infraction, and it'll be a point for Team USA. I told you, he set a high standard, that head referee did, when he called the double contact on Phil Dahlhauser. Now he's been keeping the standard. He's been very consistent.
Nick Lucena with that service. Trailing Brazil by just two, but the USA must win the second set. Floats the ball short once again. Alisson over on two from Bruno Schmidt. Brazil three clear, 13-10. Good play from Bruno Schmidt, quick thinking.
It's so hard to go over on two when you have that off arm on the right side. He has to wait for the ball to clear his body, but he's so good at it.
Oh, good play from Alisson. And he's powers the ball down to go four clear.
Alisson all over the net right there. They tried to set the ball a little bit too tight. And Alisson, you cannot allow that to happen. He's just going to put it away. Nick tries to block it with one hand. Phil moving into that angle, gets caught with it. But Brazil right now doing everything right.
Bruno Schmidt so effective with his service run in the first set, looking for the same in the second. Here's Nick Lucena. He's been read. Alisson sets the ball up for Bruno Schmidt. Oh, and again.
They are everywhere on the court. Everything going the way of the Brazilians right now. The United States looks a little baffled because they haven't been able to figure anything out. The Brazilians, every time the United States puts a shot somewhere, they seem to have an answer.
Good shot from Nick Lucena.
That's a solid shot down the line for Nick Lucena. We mentioned last week in Xiamen, China, that these Americans won. And for Nick, it was the first time he won an FIVB event. Going into that, he was 0-6 in finals in FIVB competition. So this is a new era for Nick Lucena. He's playing in the big leagues, and he's making it happen.
Oh, he's playing in the big league, and he's playing against the big boys today, because Alisson can do no wrong. The Brazilians riding high with their confidence, and their tactical game plan is working, almost going to perfection now.
It really is. Everything going right for Brazil. The United States trying to switch up strategies, but it's not working. Oh, wow, nice extension by Bruno. You see that, Bruno? He makes no decisions. He just goes after the ball in a full lead situation, waits to see the shot, and then he takes off. This shot is nice and precise in the corner, but Bruno gets his hand on it. He just never knows. More times than not, he'll get that ball up and keep it in play. There's the side-out attempts. 10 for Brazil, 90% success rate for Bruno Oscar Schmidt, only a 73% success rate for Lucena. And look at the attempts, 33 attempts for Nick Lucena. Talk about getting a day's full of work. He's getting basically every single serve from the Brazilians.
Here is Lucena with service, serving to Alisson. Here comes the big powerhouse of the Brazilian team. Bounce that ball down to the sand. Team USA have no answer to that kind of attack. Brazil draw 5 points clear.
The crazy thing is usually you have an answer or something you could tell the United States to make an adjustment, but they're not necessarily playing poorly. The Brazilians are just doing absolutely everything right.
Oh, and everything seems to be going wrong for the Americans. Alisson again on the attack for Brazil, and again successfully. 6 points clear, 18-12 and 1-0. Brazil are looking good for the gold medal here.
Yeah, sometimes you just have these matches that a team is absolutely on fire. You try to stay out there as long as possible and reverse things. But Brazil right now, every bounce, every shot going their way. That's off the left hand of Phil Dahlhauser and down for yet another point. They're just 3 points away from that $100,000.
Dahlhauser and Lucena finally get a point back on the board.
Now it's time for Phil. I know he hasn't had success serving. He's got to erase that out of his mind. Go back to serve, because I've seen him run off 3 and 4 points at a time, but you have to do one right here to get the ball rolling.
Great play. Bruno Schmidt looks to finish it. Alisson sets for his partner. No, he gives it back to Alisson, who does finish it. 19-13 to Brazil. The rally has the crowd on their feet, nothing but applause, but Brazil can do no wrong.
Unfortunate dig by Nick. He was in the right position, dug the ball over the net. Taking a look at this great rally. Here's a replay. Bruno Oscar Schmidt passes the ball, comes in the middle of the court, blasts it right at Nick. Controlled dig. Nick just keeps it in play so that they get another opportunity. Here's Phil at the net waiting. And then there's the dig. Nick would love to have back. It goes over the net instead of staying on the United States side. And then the rest is history. Bruno and Alisson putting it to the ground once again.
Nick Lucena at the net for the USA. Good shot. And this is what the crowd want to see, is the Americans digging deep now. Can they turn this around? It will be quite remarkable if they take this to three sets. But if they can find their rhythm, some of the confidence that they showed in the pool play earlier in this tournament, it could happen. Oh, but not with the Brazilians and Bruno Schmidt powering down shots like that. It is match point for Brazil. They've come out in this gold medal match firing on all cylinders from the first ball, giving the Americans no room for rest and very little room for error. Great shot from Nick the Quick. Side switch. But Brazil 2015 with their second match point.
This is huge right now. History in the making right now. The record purse worth $100,000 for international competition on the line, and all Brazil has left is to receive serve and put it away.
They've already broken the record for earnings in one season on the FIVB World Tour with such success. 5 golds for Bruno Schmidt and Alisson, and they're about to take that $405,000 tally to $500,000. They need to side out here against the Americans. What can Phil Dahlhauser and Nick Lucena fight back? Alisson sets the ball up for his partner Bruno Schmidt. It's all over. It's gold for Brazil. $100,000 and yet another gold medal performance. Their sixth in the 2015 season. Alisson and Bruno Schmidt, the duo of the 2015, the FIVB World Tour. They may have been beaten by the Americans in pool play, but in the big finale to the Swatch Beach Volleyball FIVB World Tour Finals, the Brazilians raised their game and beat the Americans by 2-0.
That's one of those matches that you just walk off kind of shaking your head if you're Team USA. The Brazilians came out. They were a little bit hungrier. They were definitely more on point and sharp from the first whistle, and they never let up. There was no lapse in the Brazilians' game. They took it to the Americans, and they showed who's playing the best volleyball right now in the world. How about this team? Six championships in the last seven events. No one bigger than this. Here it is. Match ball, Bruno getting up, splitting the defense, going right between the blocker, big Phil Dahlhauser at the net, and Nick Lucena in the backcourt. Bruno Oscar Schmidt at 6 feet tall, playing a lot bigger this afternoon. He was incredible, as was his partner, Alisson.
Dane, it all started at the World Championships, of course, in June. They took the gold there and then have never looked back since. Winning in Gstaad, the Grand Slam in Yokohama, Long Beach, then the Grand Slam in Poland. And they've just wrapped up the biggest one of the season here in Fort Lauderdale. A record-breaking prize purse of $100,000. And that record of mighty clashes between the USA and Brazil now goes Brazil 32, the USA 30. Maybe a little more training for Dahlhauser and Nick Lucena, but if anybody can stop the powerhouse of Brazil, that American duo can. Maybe they're not quite just ready yet.
Not ready yet, I would completely agree. I mean, Nick and Phil are playing at an extremely high level, but this team is in a class of its own right now. The Brazilians know when to switch gears and get to that next level. As we mentioned, they lost in pool play, but this was a completely different team here in the finals. They were hungry, they took it to them, and they showed maybe a preview of what we might see next year in Rio de Janeiro in the Olympic Games. Again, Dr. Ari Graça taking pictures with the Brazilians. He's the president of the FIVB. He's also Brazilian. He's had quite an afternoon celebrating with two Brazilian champions, the men and the women.
That's correct. And of course, Larissa Talita taking the gold in the women's competition. And now Bruno Schmidt and Alisson taking the gold in the men's. Some impressive statistics here as we break down the play. But as you can see, the effective positioning, attacking, blocking, even down to the aces, is all lies on the Brazilian side. 25 to 21, 3 to 1, 3 to 1, and more service errors from the USA at 4 to 2 clearly gives us the top team, not only of this Swatch Beach Volleyball FIVB Tour Finals, but the top team of the season by far. Let's go down to the center court with Casey McTavish, who is chatting to the champions of the world and Brazil.
You're the world champions. You're now the World Tour Final champions. What is the key to your success?
There is no key, not at all. Even if they had, I won't tell you anyway, but no, I'm just kidding. There is no key. Like, just like try to turn all the time the moment, like just think about that, the way that we're thinking, the way that we're playing. Like, we have, like, we put all your friendship and our passion about this sport inside the court. I think it's just all about this.
They beat you in pool play. You're playing them here in front of 4,000 people. What was the difference in this match?
You know what? Like, it was so hot in that match in the pool. Right in the beginning of the week was, like, we can't extend, like, stay in the court. Like, way high. But even if that, like, I don't want to, like, take the credit of those guys. They play pretty well in the pool, but we came, like, more mentally and with way more focus for that match. We knew that we needed to play strong until the beginning until the end. So I think that was, like, the changes for us.
Alisson, are you happy?
I'm very happy because it's a great final. And congratulations, Lucien and Dahlhauser for me. It's a better team. But Bruno is perfect today.
Thank you. Thank you. And Bruno, what are you going to do with the money?
that's none of your business. I'm just kidding. No, guys, thank you anyway. Thank you.
Thank you.
Well done, Casey, because Alisson does not like to give interviews to any reporters down there in center court. Casey getting words from both the Brazilian players. But interesting to note, they were discussing how they got beaten in pool play, but they came with a slightly different game plan and seemed to be more focused of the two teams on court in the match that mattered, Dave.
Yeah, it was a little hotter earlier in the weekend. Bruno mentioned that heat was an issue for them possibly, and Here, they stepped up their game. No matter what the conditions, heat, wind, rain, whatever it was going to be, Brazil was going to step up to an entirely different level. And that's what they did. We saw a different class of team here. You know, I think those two are the best two teams right now playing together. But Brazil's on another level, and they showed it this afternoon. I mean, they really came to play. And the Americans, they did not have what it took to win this championship, and Brazil did.
Let's go back down to Casey on the center court, who's chatting to the Americans, who have finished in second position, but still take $60,000.
You defeated Brazil in pool play. You come up a little bit short here. What happened?
They played really well, and that was probably our worst match of the tournament, but give credit to them. They made very little mistakes. They served tough, and they had some great block D. So we'll learn from it, and we'll get better.
You're the local heroes here. You have a packed stadium. How special is it to earn a silver medal at this event?
Well, silver is not what we wanted. We wanted, obviously, gold. But we had a great tournament up till today. We just kind of came out flat and never could get out of it. And, hats off to them. They played a really high-level match. They barely made any mistakes. And we couldn't put any pressure on them, serve, receive, or anything, block, defense. So they just... They're siding out at will.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Yeah, he said it best. They could just never get any traction. And an interesting note, USA just four times scored consecutive points, where Brazil had two 4-0 runs and two 3-0 runs. And that was the big difference, the consistency and the pressure. Brazil just came to play. And as Phil told you, they just couldn't get any traction on the American side.
Well, the biggest point that I'd like to glean from that interview of the American team is that Nick Lucena said, "We will learn from this. We will come back and we will play better." Today belongs to Brazil, taking gold in the men's and women's finals here at the FIVB Tour Finals. But rest assured, Germany in the women's game and the USA in the men's game will be back for more. From Nick Fellows and from Dane Blanton, many thanks for your company. We have to say goodbye for now. But what a finale to the 2015 FIVB World Tour here in Fort Lauderdale, USA. So we prepare for the official prize-giving ceremony down in center court with the medals for both men and the women. I have to say, Dane, this has been a spectacular finale to the season, a real precursor to the Rio Olympic Games. I think we've seen a lot of the teams taking the medals here that will be the main players come August 2016, when the biggest tournament in 4 years takes place in Rio de Janeiro.
No question about it. This was a precursor. That's what we were calling it. This may be a preview of what we see in Rio, and it was first class all the way. You know, no one knew what kind of treat we were going to be treated to with Hannes Jagenhofer, the president of the major series, but bringing this finals here to the United States, it couldn't have turned out any better. The crowd was incredible, the weather incredible, a dream matchup in the finals. on the men's side with USA going up against Brazil. It was perfect, and I think this is going to be the beginning of some huge things in beach volleyball.
No, I think you're absolutely right, Dane. And what's been pleasing for me is that it's not just been about the United States of America and Brazil. We had a German team in the final. The Dutch brought two teams to the last rounds of the competition. Europe is getting stronger in a sport that is so often dominated by the USA. You're a gold medalist yourself, or by the Brazilians from South America.
Absolutely. And let's not forget the Canadians. They are becoming stronger each and every time. But Brazil did end up with the last laugh on top of the podium in both divisions, and they are showing why they are so successful. They have made a point this season.
In third position in the women's competition, Barbara and Agatha from Brazil. Randy Stocklus, one of the veteran American beach volleyball players, presenting the third place medals. So good to see the Germans on the podium claiming a silver medal. A great performance from Laura Ludwig and Kira Volkenhorst. $60,000 worth of prize money. They'll be delighted with that. But most importantly, to split the Brazilians in the competition.
Yeah, I knew they might be in trouble. They had beaten the Brazilians, Larissa and Talita, two times previous. And you better believe that woke up the Brazilians and they got revenge. But happy with a second place, the Germans.
The silver medals presented by Carol Hudson, the Vice President of Sports Development at the Greater Fort Lauderdale Convention and Visitors Bureau. We know it as Hello Sunny. Here's the big one. Larissa Talita of Brazil, take gold. The gold medals presented by Dr. Are Gracia, the President of the Federation Internationale of Volleyball, FIVB. They really were the class act. Talita and Larissa, Talita Antunes and Larissa Franca.
You better believe Ari Graça hoping he can repeat this type of a performance come Rio in 2016 for the Olympic Games. But a lot of pride there, having a great day, of course, having both his men's and women's team atop the podium and playing with such sportsmanship and class and professionalism. They're all really great role models.
The 2015 World Champions claim their eighth gold of this season. What a way to wrap up the tour. Both of those Brazilian teams on your screens have already been selected to their Olympic squad for Rio in 2016. And I have to say, Larissa and Talita will be the team to beat for the Olympic gold in the summer of 2016.
Yeah, from here on out, it's about fine-tuning for this top team of Larissa and Talita. Getting better, if you can imagine, if they can get any better. They're playing so well.
Robert McKenzie presenting the trophy, the vice mayor to the city of Fort Lauderdale. Fort Lauderdale has done a brilliant job in hosting this competition.
Presented by the CEO of Beach Majors Company, Anders Eihofer.
And the biggest prize money in the history of international beach volleyball is presented by Hannes Jägerhofer, the CEO of the Beach Majors Company, the man that is often credited with really putting this sport on the world map. He's making it bigger and better just about every time we come to the sand. $100,000 to the Brazilians, Larissa and Talita.
Yeah, Hannes Jägerhofer has taken beach volleyball to another level. You know, I started playing in his events back in 98, and what they've become is absolutely incredible. Breaking the record, $100,000 for first place, and such a professional event. Everyone I talked to was just completely impressed by the way this tournament has been run. He has set the standard and the mark higher than anybody.
Well, as our main sponsor, Swatch present each and every one of the medal winners with watches. And that falls down to Andre Hernandez, the brand manager for Swatch here in the United States of America.
Swatch has been involved for such a long time, and they have become synonymous with the FIVB World Tour.
And if they haven't got enough to keep hold of. Carol Hudson provides our winners with a stand-up paddleboard. And with $100,000 worth of prize money, maybe they can afford to check that in as excess luggage and take it home to Brazil Day.
No question about it. You're not going to carry that on and fit it in the overhead. They're definitely going to have to pack that up and send it back down to Brazil. But what a great prize for the champions.
Gold and bronze for Brazil as we stand for the Brazilian national anthem.
National anthem for the winner, Brazil.
Well, wherever the Brazilians play across the world on the FIVB World Tour, they always manage to find a good contingent of the crowd, and they have been absolutely delighted at the play of the Brazilian teams here at the Swatch Beach Volleyball FIVB World Tour Finals. Gold and bronze to the Brazilians. I was so impressed with the German women, Lara Ludwig and Kira Balkenhorst, making sure that the European champions show that the quality, strength and depth of European beach volleyball is on the upward curve, as well as here in the United States of America, and of course, down in Brazil, in South America.
Lara Ludwig, I think, they're having a good time. Little selfie pole right there, taking their shots with the other teammates. But you're right, Laura Ludwig and Balkenhorst really representing for Germany and playing some of the best volleyball that I've seen them play in their entire career. Balkenhorst only going to get better at 24. Ludwig, 29, just a youngster as well. Already two Olympic Games under her belt. She's always having a good time. Personality there on the left-hand side, Laura Ludwig, really bringing some excitement to this final.
Dane, if I had to ask you to pick your favorite player of the women's tournament, would that come from the German duo, or would you go to the ever-successful winners, Larissa and Talita?
Well, I mean, you know, the Germans might be, Ludwig might be a crowd favorite, but in terms of if you had to give an MVP, it would be a co-MVP for me, and it would be the Brazilian duo. Talita and Larissa played so cool and calm. You know what? They just have confidence beyond belief because they have had so much success, winning six tournaments before this one, now having seven under their belt. It's just incredible how well they have played, breaking the record, going $435,000 in one season, breaking the old record of $409,750 that Larissa held with her old partner, Juliana. So it's been a groundbreaking and record-breaking season for the Brazilian duo of Talita and Larissa, and how fitting for them to end winning the FIVB World Tour Finals.
Let's move on to the men's awards ceremony. Once again, Brazil will be taking the gold and the bronze, with the American duo Phil Dolhauser and Nick Lucina taking the silver.
Third place, bronze medalist, representing Brazil, Pedro Solberg Evandro.
Pedro Solberg and Evandro from Brazil taking the bronze medal, defeating the Dutch duo of Moussen and Brouwer in that bronze medal match. This is the team that we've dubbed the experiment. Two blockers are being brought together to create a new style of play, a dynamic type of play. It's very interesting how they progress, how they gain in confidence. I like their style more and more, I have to admit, Dane.
Yeah, and they're getting their medals from the legendary Randy Stoklos right there. You're absolutely right, it's an experiment. Two blockers, who plays defense? Well, they've been trading off, and it seems to be working. The question is, can it work to get them to the very top of the podium? We know they can get around that third place, but can they win consistently?
Now let's talk about Dolhauser and Nick Lucina, who we know, if you've been with us watching the big match earlier, have to settle for the silver. Work in progress, but that work in progress is on the upward curve. These guys are learning, particularly Nick seems to be learning so much so soon. Will they be ready in time for Rio to reverse these positions?
Oh, they'll be ready, no question about it. You'd only have to go back to the end of August when they played their first event, and that was in Long Beach. And think about it, four out of five tournaments that they've played in, they've been in the finals. So this is the real deal. They are going to be strong, and they're only going to get better. Nick will get used to playing in finals, and he'll get used to taking care of business. This will be a learning experience. We heard him say it in that interview.
And the gold medal goes to Alisson and Bruno Schmidt, their sixth gold in the 2015 season. They thought the high point of their tour was the World Championships in June. Oh no, they've took this competition here by storm. They were defeated by the Americans in pool play, but came back to the final match of the day with a different focus, a tactical game plan, and my oh my, did they deliver and stake their claim for that $100,000 prize. I have to say, I didn't expect them to win the final quite as easily as they did. A clear indication to the rest of the world that they don't just come out here and play. They do their homework before they come to center court.
Yeah, to have won six of the last seven events is just incredible for these guys. And they're doing everything right. They're surrounded by a great team. They're doing their studying. And they lost early in pool play to the Americans, but they turned it around and they won when it really counted. And this team is a team to be reckoned with. They're playing at a very high level, and you're going to have to do your homework to beat them. They're going to be there every time. They're hungry, and they're not complacent. They don't expect, they expect to win, but they don't think that anything's a given, and they go out there and focus every time, and that's what's scary. They took that final extremely serious, and the Americans didn't have an answer for them. I don't think it was that the Americans played poorly. It's that the Brazilians kind of took them out of their game.
Yeah.
And played on a higher level, and that's what it's going to take if U.S. is going to take them down. But there's that $100,000 record-breaking first-place prize money being handed by, again, Hannes Jagenhofer, the president of the Major Series, who's taken beach volleyball to another level of professionalism.
Well, Dane, you won Olympic gold in Sydney in 2000. How were your pre-match or pre-Olympic tournaments for you? Were there ups and downs? Did you have some good wins? Did you have some good losses? Most importantly, what would your advice now be to the American duo who have to settle for silver here with regards to upping their game, because they're going to have to go to Brazil's backyard where they believe the sport was invented, in Copacabana Beach, to try and reverse this result?
Yeah, well, you know, Phil Dolhauser, he doesn't need any advice. He's been in 2008. He's won a gold medal of his own. And when I won my gold medal, I wasn't dominating going into that Olympics. So we kind of surprised a lot of people in one of the biggest upsets in history, whereas Phil, he's in the mix every week. It's just going to be that extra push. And if he can get his partner, Nick Lucena, who hasn't been playing on the level that Phil has for the last 10 years, if he can bring him up to that level and get him prepared for these massive, big-time matches, and then they can really put up a good fight against Brazil.
Beautiful trophies, Swatch watches, and even a stand-up paddleboard, as we all stand up for the Brazilian national anthem. Thank you. A record-breaking competition here in Fort Lauderdale and a record-breaking season for both the men's and women's gold medalists here at the Swatch Beach Volleyball FIVB Tour Finals. Alisson and Bruno Schmidt unbeatable for the last seven major competitions. What a brilliant way to wrap up the 2015 tour here in the United States of America. And as Brazil hosts the 2016 Summer Olympic Games, their beach volleyball players are in peak form. The million-dollar question, not the $100,000 question, is are they peaking too soon in their quest for Olympic glory? That story will unfold throughout the 2016 season and into the Summer Olympics next August. Congratulations to the Americans taking the silver, putting on a great show, winning every one of their pool play matches, but just to be outplayed by Alisson and Bruno Schmidt in the finale. And of course, Brazil taking the bronze with Pedro Solberg and Evandro, their young rising stars. That brings us to the end of the 2015 tour here. What a fantastic finale. It really does set the standard for the 2016 FIVB World Tour and, of course, the Summer Olympic Games. From Nick Fellows and the former Olympic champion, Dane Blanton, many thanks for your company. I'm sure you'll agree it has been a fantastic week here in Fort Lauderdale. It brings us to say goodbye for now. Thanks for your company.
Goodbye. Have fun.